Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. Thank you and good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
When you are in a land where people eat snake, you should take its middle piece. That's what my grandmother told in my younger days to get rid of my inhibitions. And with this, let me share something about my journey towards unknown destiny. I was born to a farmer parents in Kerala in 1977 as their elder son. And they named us Anish. And according to Google, Anish is derived from negative prefix an followed by isha, means processor. And a combination of this means one who has no master. And it is applied to both Lord Vishnu as well as Shiva, the protector and destroyer of this world. Of course, this is Google says, I don't believe. And I grabbed attention from everyone for 4 years till my brother came. And after that, he has been pampered, I have been beaten. And even today, he is enjoying all attention than me. The biggest loss of my life came when I was 11 years old. I lost my father to a medical problem. And after that, my life was different. I completed my engineering diploma in 1996 and started my career as a construction engineer in Kerala. And my first project was a power plant project, and I completed that project in early 2000. And after that, I moved to Gujarat, where I spent almost 10 years working in various construction projects. In Gujarat, I had the fortune to work for some of the mega projects which has got national importance, like Reliance Petrochemical projects, Ultratech cement plant, and roads, bridges, highways, and all. And I was there for almost all the states in that wonderful state. And even if someone asks me which one you will choose, either Kerala or Gujarat, I will definitely say I will choose Gujarat over Kerala. That was the affection I got with that state. In 2007, February, I met a beautiful and simple girl in Kerala named Maya. And in August 2007, we married. And during the progression of our life, and she conceived. And after confirming that good news, I had only one request to Maya, that I need a baby girl. On Teacher's Day of 2008, a baby girl came to my life as I wished. And we named us Ritika, my elder daughter. In early 2010, after completing 10 years of service in Gujarat-based company, I decided to leave that company, and then I joined a Acker Power Gas, an MNC, engineering MNC in Mumbai. In Acker, my first job was in Pune, it was a L'Oreal cosmetic plant, where Maya and Ritika accompanied me there. In late 2011, I completed the construction of my new houses in Kerala, and I shifted my family to Kerala, and by that time my elder daughter started education. Since I was in a construction field, it is not possible to carry them along, because sometimes I may be here and then after 6 months I will be in some other sites. And since 2011, they are there in Kerala and I am here. And I go to Kerala once in 3 months or so whenever I get time. On Durgashtami day of 2012, another baby girl came to my house. And we named after that Durga. She is Durga, my second daughter. And I am more attached to my family. And the four ladies of my life, my mother, Maya, and my kids, are aware of this fact. And they are expert in utilizing my emotional attachment to them. And if anyone wants to know how to utilize my emotional attachment, you should get it, learn from my daughters. They are expert in that. After completing L'Oreal project, and I again went to Gujarat for another project, and I completed that project in 2014, and since then I am in my Mumbai office. I studied in a vernacular medium school, and hence I fear a lot to speak in English with others, because I fear a lot of grammatical mistakes, and that somehow pulls me back. And I often confuse with has been, have been, should have been, could have been phrases. This always confuses me. You may be feeling that I am eccentric to say this one, but that is a fact. And what else to say? So far the journey was not planned by me. I was not sure whether I will go to Gujarat, I will land to Mumbai and all. But this journey was so far unknown. That is the reason I put my caption as journey to unknown destiny. With this, over to you, Toastmasters.